We've got a lot of news to get to on Tesla this morning, starting with another departure at the top. The company is losing its general counsel after just 2 months on the job. Phil LeBeau joins us more with the details. Phil.
And Melissa, this is a departure that has people saying, another top executive leaving Tesla. The reason here is that Dane Butswinkas, who has been the general counsel since December, has decided it's not the right cultural fit for him. At least that's what the company is saying at this point. He is going back to his law firm, or the law firm he was at in Washington. That is the outside counsel, by the way, for Tesla. So he still may be doing some work with the company. His replacement is an 8-year veteran of the company. His name is Jonathan Chang. He becomes the new general counsel for Tesla. And for many people, this is the question of what's going on with the leadership at Tesla, because by some accounts, there have been more than 50 top executives, VP or higher, who have left over the last couple of years, though we've been unable to document whether or not that number is accurate or not. Here are some of the more prominent departures over the last 12 months. And again, these are just over the last 12 months, just a few of the prominent ones, not all of them. You've got the general counsel leaving today. Last month, the CFO announced that he is going to be retiring from the company. The general counsel was replaced in December. That was Dane Butswinkas. He only lasted a couple of months. In September, the chief accounting officer left. And in July, you had the engineering VP, Doug Field, who left the company. So as you take a look at shares of Tesla, guys, this is that question that hangs out there for analysts and for those who are Tesla bulls. What's going on with the leadership at Tesla? Clearly, this is Elon Musk's company. And anybody who works for him knows that it's his company. And in this case, Dane Butswinkas apparently decided it was just not the right fit for him.
Yeah, you know, Phil, this is the general counsel for a guy who had to reach a settlement with the SEC that required him to put 3 board members to not be the chairman anymore. I mean, I can imagine there's some friction in that relationship if the general counsel is trying to do their job.
And the question becomes, and we don't know this, David, but the question becomes, did Dane Butswinkas or did the previous general counsel, were they frustrated that they were trying to communicate with Elon Musk, look, you have got to honor the SEC agreement by the letter of the law? Now, Tesla is quick to point out with this announcement today that this does not change the terms of the SEC agreement or that Tesla plans to honor the commitments made in that agreement. But you had this tweet overnight from Elon Musk, which has people raising their eyebrows again, saying, well, first he says that they're going to have 500,000 as a production total for 2019. Then a couple of hours later, he brings it back and says, well, it's 400,000. I was mistaken in saying 500,000. But those are the kind of things that go out there, guys, and people say, who's actually monitoring, or is there somebody actually monitoring what Elon Musk is tweeting out?
I think the question is, who's able to monitor Elon Musk?
Sure.
There's probably somebody monitoring. There's probably somebody saying, oh, we shouldn't tweet that out. But I don't know if there's somebody at the company who's capable of saying, hey, Elon, don't do this, and Elon Musk actually listens to them. I mean, that is the concern of a lot of investors.
Right.
When the SEC agreement was agreed to, people were extremely, you know, relieved that there could be some restrictions on what Elon Musk may or may not do on Twitter. And this sort of raises the question of, can there be controls? Can there
actually
be controls?
Remember, part of that agreement, Melissa, was that they take the chairman title away from Elon Musk, and that they put a chairman in there, and that the board, quote unquote, be stronger. That's essentially what the SEC was hoping for. Well, Elon Musk, after they named the new chairwoman, who was a board member who they elevated to that position there, after that, Elon Musk said, you know what, I'm essentially the chairman. I'm essentially running the company. He didn't say he was the chairman, but he made it very clear that he still calls the shots of the company. And so that is the concern that you have from investors, that if something's really going to change, then it has to change. And if it's not going to change, well, then you know that as an investor, and that raises red flags for some people.
Yeah, you don't want to do something again that raises the hackles of the SEC, I would think. Next time it's going to be a bit harder to settle, potentially, if there is something, Phil.
Good point.